Hello Geminis, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you and your person. So on the one side will be your energies, on the other side will be the energies of the person you are dealing with, and then the most likely outcome. So let's see what's there for Geminis. Okay, we have the Two of Swords on your side. Let's see what's there on your person's side. The Queen of Pentacles on your person's side. The most likely outcome. Eight of Pentacles, okay. So on your side we have the Two of Swords, which means that you are trying to take a decision. I was saying trying to take an action. Okay, anyway, that's also right. If you take a decision, only then you'll take action. So with the Two of Swords, you are trying to take a decision, trying to just contemplate as to what is right, what is wrong, and you're just being in touch with yourself, being very intuitive, cut off from everyone, not even perhaps communicating with the person you are dealing with over here. Or if you are dealing, then it is a very minimal communication. Okay, so that is what it is. Trying to take a decision over here, over something. You're holding something really tight close to your chest. Your grip is very firm on something, whatever this is. Maybe this is a relationship. We'll see as we progress in the reading, but there is something which you're holding on to. That's what I can say. Maybe it's the grip is, you're holding on to something close to your chest. Let's see what it is. Here with the Queen of Pentacles, again, this person is, your person is again being nostalgic, not taking much action over here. Taking that time off, perhaps because you two are not communicating, maybe that is the reason. And with the Eight of Pentacles, you will be working together, I guess, on this relationship. You're working hard, either already or will be working. On the bottom of that deck, though I don't take these cards, but suddenly I'm drawn to the fact that at the bottom of this deck also is the Devil card. I did have a look at it, but I kept it because normally I don't include them in the readings. And as soon as I picked up this card, again there is a Devil over here. So maybe there is some sort of an addiction, there is some sort of repeated pattern, some sort of habit which needs to be released perhaps, and maybe that is what it is talking about. You're holding or gripping it close to your chest, a tight hold on something. Let's see, it's getting interesting. Let's see what it is. But the Devil really, I think, has something to do with your reading today, because it is talking about some addictions, something perhaps which needs to be released so that you can come out of it, which makes you fall in a repeated patterns or repeated behaviors. There's something which is not letting you come out of it, okay, and you need to release that perhaps. Let's see. Anyway, so why is this Two of Swords here for Geminis? Okay, so we have the Five of Cups, the Knight of Swords, okay, and the Ten of Pentacles. Two more cards. I wanted to pull out one, but two have come, so I'm taking them. We have the Two of Cups and the Two of Swords again. Okay. It's getting interesting. Let's see what is this Queen of Pentacles here for. Okay, we have the Six of Wands, Page of Wands, the World, and more, Eight of Swords, okay, I'll take five here also, and the Ace of Wands. Since I've taken five there, I'm taking five here, Ace of Wands, okay. Let's see, why is this Eight of Pentacles here for? The Sun, beautiful. High Priestess, good. The King of Wands, good. It's good. At least the outcome is good. We have again, we have the Four of Cups over here, the Five of Cups, and the Four of Wands here. Okay, that was Six of Wands. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've taken five cards for you. So, with the Two of Swords on your side, okay, now I get it. It's late. Well, it came out like this. Then we have the Five of Cups, the Knight of Swords, the Ten of Pentacles, and then came the Two of Cups hiding behind the Two of Swords. It was like this. I think that is the message for you. So you're trying to take a decision on this Two of Cups. You're trying to take a decision on this relationship. That is what is important over here. This is what you're trying to make a decision on. And yeah, got it. So the Two of Swords, definitely you're trying to, this, you are really, there is a very passionate relationship. Not only you are really passionate about it, but I guess it is a relationship itself which is very passionate, very beautiful, and you want a commitment with this person and they want a commitment, and whatever it is, the only thing, you are seeking a long-term commitment. You want to have a relationship, a family with the person, and this is what it is. This is what you're trying to take a decision on. And what I feel here is, why do I get the initial vibe is the same and still I'm feeling the same, that you have a past. The reason of this Two of Swords is that you were left very, very upset and heartbroken by someone who just left you. Perhaps you were not even aware of the fact that this person is going to leave you. It's something like that which I'm getting. Someone left you secretly. That's what I'm getting. Secretly in the sense, suddenly at least. You were not secretly in the sense that you were not even aware of the intentions of this person. And this person left you immediately. Very fast. It wasn't a slow and a gradual thing. It was just very fast. This person was just out of your life. And you were very, very heartbroken because of this relationship. The way it happened, the way things happened. And you're not able to come out of this. Since a long time, you're not even able to focus on anything else, totally disinterested in whatever else life is offering you, whatever else is still there in your life. You're totally disinterested in that because you are totally glued to this heartbreak. But this person left you very fast, and that is the reason that you are holding this very firmly close to your chest. As I said, you have a firm grip of these memories and this heartbreak close to your chest, and you are finding it very, very tough to release it. Okay, you're really finding it very, very tough to release it. Though you are, it's all over your head all the time. It's really tough for you to get rid of it. And the energy over here, the main thing is, you are now trying to take a decision over something which you know is a relationship material, but you don't want to mess up things again. You don't want a heartbreak again. Okay, and that is why you are taking such a long time. You're trying to take a decision which you're not able to make up your mind. You're just following your instincts, which is very good. And here with the Queen of Pentacles, we have the Six of Wands, the Page of Wands, the World, the Eight of Swords, and the Ace of Wands. So what I'm feeling here is that this person is a really very lively person, very happy person, a happy-go-lucky type of a person. This person really doesn't have anything back, holding them back, or anything from the past, I should say, which is caging them or to restrict or refrain them from this new beginning. The only thing is, with the Eight of Swords energy which I am picking up here, is that this reluctancy in their moving forward also is because of you. Over here, they really want a new beginning with you. They really, really don't have any baggage, at least I should say. I won't say that they don't have a past. They may be having the past, but they don't have a baggage from the past. This person is very happy in their own life. They are very victorious. Maybe they're a celebrity. They are very, very bubbly and full of energy. It's a new world into which they really want to step in with you, and they really want to have a new beginning with you. So there's nothing wrong, nothing negative I should say, on this person's energy. But what I feel is, with the Eight of Swords has come up, But the energy which I feel here is that this person is also not able to, or it is a forced thing that obviously if you don't give any signal, how can this person make a move? It's something like that. Okay. So this person is also, it's a forced restraint on this person from your side, because you are not giving them that much of leverage or that much of a signal or clue or that much of a lift, I should say, that this person is not able to make a move because of you. Okay. So this is what it is. If you give them a little bit of liberty, a little bit of signal, a little bit of your interest has to be shown to them. If you really behave in such a way that this person is forced to keep quiet, it's something like that. This person is forced to keep quiet. They really want to have a new beginning with you. Okay, and here with the Eight of Pentacles, as I said, both of you working together hard for this relationship. And here we have the Sun, the High Priestess. Beautiful, happiness is coming in. Be in touch with your intuition. That's what you are doing, and you, for taking a decision, you're already using your intuition with the High Priestess. Again, give it the time, whatever it needs, but yes, don't take it so slow also that you lose the grip of the relationship itself. And here again we have the Four of Cups. The only problem here is that you're still too focused on the past. You just need to focus on the present, because it is a very, very enthusiastic and a passionate and a beautiful relationship. Perhaps it is going to fill your life also with happiness, because the person here with the Four of Wands coming up again, which is happiness, which is celebrity, celebrations, celebrity I'm seeing. Maybe this person is a celebrity whom you are dealing with. So with the Four of Wands, the Knight of Wands, it's all happiness coming in the moment you start focusing on what